Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we got that Golf here, okay? We're going to show you how to fix transmission problem on it. And now on that Golf, what happened? We got it at an auction. You know, you can check the video out. We have it on Mobile Mechanics, so it's in the description, so you can see what was the problem with it. When it gets hot, it doesn't shift right. It's really, really hard shifting. Second, third gear, almost any gear, but first, second and third you can feel it really, really big time. It's like you almost jump in the car when it shifts. So what you need to do, that's a valve body problem. There is one valve that you can replace inside. So we'll show you how to remove and replace the whole valve body because we have a parts car, so we'll show you and how it's going to fix the problem. So stay with us now. All right guys, so we took a few components off. You can see bumper, you can see headlights, but you don't need to do that. We're just doing some other work. We have many videos, feel free to check them out. So now with the T30, okay, that's the transmission oil pan. And on the bottom, there is actually a place where you can drain the oil, and that thing is pretty tight. It's with a T30, the star looking bit, okay? And get a good container, clean container, collect the oil. We recommend to do a flush and change the oil, but we want to first just replace the valve body, drive it for a little bit and replace it after that. Okay, and you can see the oil doesn't look bad. Most people think with an oil change it will go away, but it will not. What happened, I think that's a pressure valve, and when the oil gets hot it loses pressure, and that's why it shifts funny as well. Okay, so now we are ready to install the drain plug. It's almost empty. You always collect more inside, otherwise you have to like leave it overnight open, and when you remove the valve body of course you will leak a little bit more out, so you need to get something, make sure you don't make a mess, because those transmissions they keep quite a bit of oil. Just get it tight now, don't leave it for later because you might forget to get it tight and driving down the road, if you lose it you're in big trouble. And now we need to go ahead and remove the rest of them with a 10 millimeter socket, all the bolts on the oil pan. Okay, you can see that's what they look like. Okay, so all together we'll see how many bolts. Once we remove it, I'll be able to show you exactly where they're on the oil pan, and we'll check what it looks like inside. It's always good to clean, do a flush, change the filter, but always, always use original manufacturer oil. Never go with anything else, because we've seen so many with messed up transmissions because of that. Okay, last one now. So you need to hold it for the last one because it's going to drop and you have oil, so make sure it doesn't spill on you, get on you. Okay, you can see how much it's going to leak on it. So we'll just empty it in this container now there. And you can see we're almost to the valve body right there. And you can see it's super clean underneath. So it doesn't have any black stuff. It's definitely not clutch packs or anything like that. Okay, so next we need to remove the filter. Okay. You can see the valve body already, so the filter is with a few 10 millimeter socket bolts, hopefully, three of them. So go ahead, take those off, and you see you'll be leaking some oil and making a mess. Okay, filter will come off now. Okay guys, first thing we need to do now, you can see that, okay, that nut right there for the shifter, there is a few things that are bent so it doesn't come off. Let me see if I can get a little bit of a closer view so you know what I'm talking about. You need to straighten those so you can, okay, you can see, so you can actually go ahead and take the nut off. They're bent that way so the nut will not come off from vibrations and cause damage inside. Okay, so we got it now. We'll go ahead and take it off now. Okay, just a nut, so be careful not to drop it, okay? Okay, so that thing came off as well. It's not in the way anymore. And now we'll see if we can pull it out. Okay, it will come off, but it's just a little bit tight. Okay, so you can just pull it out like that. Okay, that's what it looks like right here. Okay, so now to remove that wire, you need to lift that tooth up there. Okay, get it out of the way because underneath there is a bolt with a 10 millimeter socket for the valve body. Okay, right there. Okay, so we're going to take that wire apart. Okay, so it's not in the way anymore at all. Okay, this one here. And the white one is towards the front of the car. And we need to do a few more there for those solenoids. You need to remember the way you take them off. It's good to always take a picture. Just mark which one goes where so you know. Okay, we pull the first one out and you need to do the same procedure for all of them. It's not the easiest job. You always have to be careful working on the transmission valve bodies. Never get it dirty. Try to do it inside so dust doesn't fly inside, because just a little bitty piece of dirt over here can cause it not to work properly. Okay, we have that blue one here that you still need to do the same thing. Just pull it out and then you need to take it apart from each other. Okay, it goes in the clips there, so we need to feed them the right way when you're putting it together. Let's see now. Oh, it always makes me a little bit nervous working on transmissions, but you can save yourself so much money, because they will definitely tell you it needs new transmission when it does not. Okay, we're going to remove that bolt there with a 10 millimeter socket so we can pull that orange wire, okay, out of there somehow. Okay, it will come off just like that. And more oil coming out. Okay, you can see it just like that. Okay, we're done with the wire, so now we're going to go ahead and remove the bolts with 10 millimeter socket, the one that holds it towards the transmission housing itself. So there is many bolts. Once we take the valve body out, guys, we will definitely show you what bolts you need to remove, because it's really hard to show you and I can't get the camera underneath it because it's still dripping oil. So you can do only so much, and you need to put the bolts in a way that you take them apart. Every bolt goes to a specific place, so you need to put them on a piece of paper where every bolt goes to. Okay, a few more there. There is many, many bolts. It's always, guys, good to check your CV boots right here. This one is broken. You can see the tie rod boot is broken, and that could lead to big play in the future, and actually even it's a dangerous situation. So always check your suspension parts. Okay, last bolt, now you have to hold it because it will try to drop on you. Okay, just like that. Okay, you come off. Okay guys, so that's what it looks like. You can see that's the whole valve body. We're not going to be messing with it. because we'll just get the one from the parts car and we'll install the new one, and that will fix the problem. So you can get a new one, new valve body, you can get them, I've seen them on eBay, brand new ones that you can get way better price than the dealer, and it's the original valve body and you can replace it. You can try the kit as well that has the one for the spring. Okay guys, so that fixed our problem. The car shifts amazing and we even sold it pretty quick. But if you have a problem with a Volkswagen transmission, always check the valve body, especially you can even get that valve to replace it. The whole kit, they sell it online. So thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.